Hey everyone, it's Namita. Welcome to an interesting episode of Edutainment. And if you're wondering what Edutainment is, it's going to be a series of education and entertainment where we will be inviting amazing men and women to share their knowledge and expertise. Our very first guest on this episode is Dr. Pooja Pandey Tripathi, who is a real superwoman. She's an entrepreneur, certified physiotherapist, volley instructor, a dancer, theater artist, a YouTuber, and a mother of two. Episode, we have spoken about the small changes that we need to incorporate in our life and how exercise should be part of our lifestyle. If you like this video, give this video a big fat thumbs up, subscribe to my channel and Dr. Pooja's channel, Arogya Physio Tips. I will link down all the social handles in the description box below. I hope you enjoy this episode, Dr. Pooja on Edutainment.
So hello, Dr. Pooja, welcome to my channel. So we have a couple of questions for you. So let's start with the pandemic question that everybody knows. It's been a year that we have been in the lockdown. What's the most common pain that people have started coming to you with?
That's very easy to answer. So because from past 1 year, there has been pandemic, people are working like we are sitting in front of computer. People are also sitting in front of the computer and they're sitting like 8 hours, 12 hours, 16 hours, because they're saying that since they are at home and there is no traveling involved, people are mailing every now and then. So they are ending up actually working more than what they used to do in office. And not everybody has an ergonomic setup, right? They don't have a table of proper length or a chair of proper length.
What is happening is, one, to look at the screen, they are bending their neck a lot, okay? Or to type in front of the screen. So what is happening here, again, the neck is coming forward. So forward head syndrome. So lot of neck pain patient. These trapezius are getting sore.
Scapula at the back, that is also paining. Then the second is middle back pain and the third is lower back pain. So these three has become so common. Also, for the people who are not working in front of the computer, in London it is different, but in India we have maid facilities, right? And if your maid is not coming and you're ending up working more, sweeping, sopping, again you end up having a back pain and neck pain. So back pain, neck pain, middle back pain is the most common pain. I think that is another pandemic which has come over.
Yeah, I agree. Even I have been working from my dining table these days. So even I have developed like quite a sore shoulder and also like lower back. If a person has already started developing these kind of pains, what would you suggest? Maybe simple remedies or exercises would you recommend?
Okay, so the first thing which I always say is a mantra. Like in Hindu, we have mantra Om Namah Shivaya, or in Christianity, there is Hey Lord. Here we have that tuck your chin in. Okay, if you tuck your chin in, automatically can't come forward, right? So you will realize every time you want to come out of it that your neck is going forward. So tuck your chin in is a very good reminder all the time to take the chin back. Second is just rolling the shoulder front and then anti-clockwise. Okay, so clockwise and anti-clockwise. Also, you can even massage your trapezius by using your hand. Second very important point is, not an exercise, but a point is, always use it at the eye level. So your computer has to be at your eye level, okay? So make sure you can elevate it by using books or by using anything, okay? Also, in our channel, Arogya Physio Tips, we have shot a video about how to correct your posture while working at home. You can actually post that link here. We have shown that if you are working in sofa, how you should work, or if you are working in dining table, how you should work, how your posture should change. Third very important point is, every 30 minutes or 45 minutes, make sure that you get up and you stretch yourself a bit, you know, stretch on the side, stretch your back little bit by touching down. So when you are stretching regularly, the circulation becomes better. And then there are less chances of spasm. Sitting without back support is absolutely no. We have to sit with back support. Okay. So if these things are carried on, I think you'll be in a much better place. Posture is very important. Second is taking mini breaks. Third is stretches.
Yeah, that's actually a very good point. We have been having continuous meetings back to back, and what happens is you switch from one meeting to another without having a gap as well. Having like that 5 minutes gap between every meeting, I can at least get up and go for a coffee break or like a washroom break or something like that. That actually very helpful.
Yeah. And remember that coffee or tea, both of them are dehydrating, and summers are coming. So hydration is very important. Have lemon juice, have water while you take a break.
I have seen the video that you recommended. So I tried to keep like a pillow backside and elevate my laptop. But usually what happens is that it's not very comfortable to like work on books.
So there is also tables available in which we can sit and stand. The best is to invest in an ergonomic table and an ergonomic chair. We can post those links here where we are using some ergonomic table.
Well, now what is ergonomic table is, it's an adjustable table. You can adjust the height. You can actually stand with the table. So the table goes up and it comes down when you are sitting. So right now I'm sitting in an ergonomic chair.
Your whole back is supported. See, you will have a hand to rest on, and you will be having the adjustable thing. So your legs are touching the ground and it's not dangling in the air, so that the circulation is proper. And it is 90 degree rules. So the hip and knee, they should be at 90 degree. Okay, so all those things. So neck straight, back supported, and hip and knee 90 degree.
And hands, of course, supported. So what happens is, if we do this or we do this, we will end up having all the wrist pains. So to avoid that, hand has to be supported. If you are using it on the table, then there has to be a padding here which support your, and then you can work.
So my next question is, you have been like a multi-talented person. I think you do physiotherapy, you have Zumba classes, you are into theater as well. You also have your own YouTube channel. So how do you manage your professional and creative side? Does it take a toll on your life?
Maybe take a toll on this life. You should ask my children and husband if it takes a toll on them. I think they're more than happy of me not coming around and shouting at them to clean the house or... So I don't think so. I'm at the much happier space by doing a multitasking. I'm a person who can't do one thing all the time because it may get boring for me. So yes, I need to treat patients on weekdays, but weekends I need to have some rehearsals of theater.
I have customized my classes. It's not exactly Zumba. I call it Wally, which is basically a dance workout. Slightly Latin based, slightly Bollywood based, and a lot on posture and belly. So it's called Wally. So those classes are now online, so I don't have to travel.
It's much easier. Just log in, do the classes and log out. My children also join in some of the rehearsals. They watch. They also learn a lot of things. I try to keep both the right and left hemisphere of my brain active. It's not bone. So for that, I like to be creative as well as be as professional as possible.
My next question is, how important is exercise in your day-to-day life? And are you supposed to exercise just for weight loss?
So there is a very good mantra. It may sound funny, but it is actually not funny. It's a mantra by Dr. Pooja Pandey Tripathi. Keep it with you. You'll be in a much happier space. The mantra is, exercise is potty. You can't avoid it as it cleanses you.
So we always think of cleansing through urine or through feces, but your body cleanses when you exercise, okay? You sweat. Your sweat glands become active when you exercise. Your muscles become active when you exercise. And exercise, when I say, is has to be a combination of three, that is cardio, strengthening, stretching. It can't be one. You can't be just running. You can't be just doing gym. You can't be just doing yoga. So it has to be a mix of all the three workout, cardio, strengthening, stretching.
When I say about weight loss, I feel the whole industry is fascinated about weight loss.
Until unless someone doesn't say weight loss, nobody gives money. Somehow if I say, I am helping you to lose weight, and people will start showering money. I completely say that you have to be more fitter than your weight loss. Okay. So if you are an obese patient and if you're not able to do 50 stairs, then that should be your concern, that I should be able to do 50 stairs and then progress to 100 stairs. So once you focus, yes, weight loss will automatically happen in the journey, but my focus should not be weight loss, because then if the weight loss is not happening like the way you want it, you will get out of it and stop exercising, which is not good for you at all. Okay. So exercise is must. And like you potty every day, you exercise every day with one day break. Yes, you can definitely take one day break. So 6 days a week, mix it, cardio, strengthening, stretching. If you actually can avoid potty, then avoid exercise also.
It's quite weird to like relate it to potty, but it actually makes sense.
Sense, right? It's just that because we can avoid it, we avoid it. But imagine if you avoid it now, then at 60s or 70s, you will be bedridden. Do you want that? No, you don't want. You want all the whatever life you have to be qualitative, to be able to give to others, rather than, you know, thinking all about, okay, how do I get up from the bed? That should not be thinking at all. So if you don't want that, you have to start now. Now as in now. When I say now, I almost refer to teenagers, you know. Nowadays, teenagers don't sleep on time, eat junk, they get PCOS, again weight gain. So all that is happening because they're not exercising, they're not doing outdoor activities so much, which if done properly, can actually reverse everything. See, first is there is always time to start new. That is one of my play dialogues, actually, ladies' compartment. Don't think, oh, I have become 50, so now I can't start. You can start right now. The earlier you start, the more benefit you will have. So weight loss should not be the mantra. Fitness should be your mantra. If you're not able to run 2 kilometers, that should be your zest. Okay, after a 2 month of training, I should be able to run 2 kilometers. That should be your mantra.
So my next question is actually related to this itself. So a lot of women, mummies or older women, they think that we have already been doing so much work in the house, cooking and cleaning the house, as well as like getting your kids ready for school and so many other works. You know, their work is like thankless job. So they think that, you know, they're already doing so much of work, so they don't need to do exercise. So what's your thought on that?
If it was earlier women, I completely agree. Okay, why? Because they didn't have washing machine, they used to wash, they didn't have powdered wheat, okay, they had to actually grind it, they had to go to the well and take the water out. If that was the technology we were having now, then yes, it was an exercise, because in the well, if you're taking out the water, you automatically do the strengthening. Or if you are squatting down and sweeping and sobbing, then those are the work. If you are just using your fingers and on the mixie and off the mixie and that is your work, then you are doing just the finger exercises, not the whole body exercise. I'm sorry to say that.
I had even done a video about Women's Day, and I was telling that if you want to gift yourself the best thing in this world, you should gift yourself time, time for yourself to pursue your fitness, to pursue your passion. Because if that is not happening, you know, today you will be fine, but tomorrow you will get frustrated, and all that frustration will come onto your children and husband, poor husband. So if the husbands want to avoid that, then tell their wife, please go away for 2 hours every day, because then they'll be at a much better mental space. They will be exercising, endorphins will get released. They will feel good about themselves. When they tone down, they feel good about themselves. They can make dancing itself as a fitness mantra, or swimming. They can make swimming itself as a fitness mantra. You have to take out time for yourself, and using your fingers is not enough, for sure. You need to use your whole body. You can have days, you can have core days, you can have back days, you can have hand days, you can have legs days. Decide and distribute your exercises accordingly.
If somebody who is going to start their fitness journey now, what would be the time you would suggest them to start with?
So it depends upon whether they have any ailment or not. Okay, if they have any ailment, for example, I have a knee pain. And that's the reason I want to come to the fitness, because I want to avoid knee pain to become arthritis. So then I need to go to a physio and start my knee strengthening exercises and then do other thing, maybe do a little bit of cycling. But if I don't have any ailment, it depends upon which age I'm starting. So for example, if I'm starting at 24, 23, 22, then I can even, you know, do an hour of exercise without fatigue. But if I am starting at 40, 42, then maybe I start with, say, 20 minutes of walk and doing some stretching, say Surya Namaskara, maybe 2 round, 3 round, and then doing some stretching. So that would help. So a 30 minute workout is ideal to start with, even 20. So when you feel that your heart rate is coming to the maximum, and what is your maximum heart rate is 220 minus your age. Okay, so that's your maximum heart rate. Everybody has these watch gadgets, not me, because I don't get inspired by watch. I am anyways an inspired person. So, but many people have those watches which shows her heart rate and stuff like that. You should not go maximum heart rate. So if you're thinking that, okay, 20 minutes I'm getting maximum heart rate, then you can stop at 20. But you need to start to stop. Okay, so start and then slowly progress. So if you're starting 20 minutes, then after 15 days, it will be 30 minutes. Then after 45 days, maybe an hour.
One of the thing that I maintain is that I keep all the gears, like clothes that I'm going to wear for the next day, ready in the night itself, so that I just push myself. There are days when I don't want to work out, but I just wear it and start with like a light workout and listen to my body initially. And then once you start doing, you automatically feel like doing another exercise, another 10 minutes, another 20 minutes. And
yes,
the feeling that you get after you are done with the exercise is really good. That
That's all the endorphins working. That's the hormones.
Yeah.
That if you're into depression, start exercising. You will get out of the depression. Apart from this, I would always suggest to meditate, because then you are much better mental space also. So pranayam and meditation. Pranayam, if you're not doing pranayam, then some breathing exercises which activates your lung, which take your attention. So the biggest cleanser in our body is our breath. And we hardly pay any attention to our breath. Okay. Hey, exhale your breath. Are you listening? How are you? We never say that. So sometimes it's okay to be with your breath. Okay. And to be with your breath, you can actually close your eyes and just concentrate on your breath for some time. I know it's difficult for a lot of people. They say that, you know, meditation doesn't happen. It didn't happen for me. I used to find it the most boring thing in this world. And my husband used to meditate flawlessly. And I used to think, can you do that? You know, I as soon as I, there'll be 200 thoughts in my mind. Okay.
I can't agree more.
Yes. But over the period of time, I can meditate. Okay. So it's a, just a practice, you know, you do it 90 days, you will be much better. Okay. You can start with 5 minutes. I'm not saying 20 minutes. You can start with 5 minutes, progress to 10 minutes, and you can make it 20. A 20-minute meditation will make sure that you are here sorted.
I have been trying to meditate for like a couple of months now. And like you said, I'm in that phase where after 10 minutes, I take off a flight. You know, I'm in that struggle phase at the moment, but I really want to increase the time of meditation. I've also noticed that a couple of situations that were making me anxious stop making me anxious now. Another thing that I have come across, and it is been there for quite some time, is cupping. And I recently saw that even in Arogya Physiotherapy Clinic that you have, you also have started doing cupping. Is it a better way of therapy?
See, it's a pain relieving therapy. Okay. Cupping is also a pain relieving therapy. So is dry needling. So is kyastium. So is myofascial release. So are electrotherapy. Basically, we have to make patient ready for the exercises. He can't exercise in pain. Okay. So I need to reduce pain. Sometimes cupping works wonderfully fully for some patient. Sometimes it doesn't work. And I need to add some other technique for that patient. So it all depends upon patient to patient. Okay. Though cupping and dry needling is very, very fancy these days, and everybody is like, seeing that red spots get very motivated to try it. So there are people who come to us for cupping. So they'll say, we want cupping. But you know, if I don't do cupping and I do a myofascial release or a chiastium or do some mobilization, then also they'll be out of pain. I need to do everything fancy to keep my clinic running. So yes, I'm doing cupping as well. There are many other things which can help.
Could you just elaborate more on those
different... Dry needling is, so how in acupuncture also you use needle, and there are trigger points. For example, if you will have pain in this area, they will have some other point where they will put needle. Dry needling is where exactly the pain is there, the needles are put around that, the trigger point area. For example, if I have pain here, all the needles will be around that area. It should not pain, because if you're not putting on nerve, it should not pain. Even the blood won't come out. So it's almost painless. Yes, if you have lot of trigger and lot of adhesion, then while putting it, it may slightly pain, but very slight, not much. The second is chiastium. It's a myofascial release technique where we use a tool and we try to release the fascia. We work on origin to insertion of the muscle and then insertion to origin of the muscle. Then there is myofascial release, which we may do with the hands by kneading, by effleurage. So by doing a lot of techniques of massage itself. Then there are a lot of electrotherapy equipments which we use. For example, we use IFT, ultrasound to release the pain, or laser, which we use to release the pain. We also use taping so that, you know, the pain which has released and you want to support those muscles, you use taping, or you want to make the posture better, you use taping where the kinetic tapes keep the posture properly.
My last question is that I know that you recently got vaccinated for COVID-19. So how was your experience with this entire vaccine process?
I was amazed, actually. I was amazed. I was given a message by the government to come and apply vaccine. All the doctors, all the medical practitioners, they were all told first to take the vaccine, followed by the senior citizen. And then we had to go to a primary healthcare center. Amazed, they were very clean. There were areas to sit. There was social distancing there. There was not much queue there.
The time they had given, we just went. We had to tell our name, show the Aadhaar card, and they vaccinated. The first dosage, after 28 days, we again get the message and we go and take the second dosage. So it was very easy. I never had to wait more than 10-20 minutes. And after the vaccination, they had told us to wait for 30 minutes. And I kept on saying, I have patience, let me go. Being government official, nobody bothers. But no, they were very strict that 30 minutes you have to wait.
There are people who are getting some fever. There are people who are getting soreness. Nothing happened to me. I was working both the days. Nothing happened to me. So I was very happy with the experience.
India is doing really great. They're leading at getting a lot of people vaccinated as well. So yeah, yes. That's an achievement for India.
Yes.
I know, like, which vaccine brand did you go for?
The Bharat one, the vaccine.
Do you think a person who has taken the vaccine from one brand has to take it from the same, or they can switch, like, the first shot from COVID Shield and the second shot from the other brand?
See, I am not a correct person to answer anything about vaccination. That's not my field at all. But I personally think they should not switch, because even if it is the same thing, everything, but the branding is different. That means there can be certain changes, and which may our body react certain way. So I think they should stick to one brand only.
Yeah, I too agree with that. So last, we have a couple of fun questions for you.
Okay. Like coffee with Karan kind of questions. You give those hampers to your people?
Sure, it will come to your house. So the first one is, what is your happiest moment as a physio?
See, every day, you know, experience that happiness. Anytime my patient is out of pain, I am become happy. Anytime my patient is not able to get up from the bed and start walking, I get happy. Anytime my patient just not able to move the fingers, hold that dumbbell and start doing strengthening, I get happy. My child is neuropediatric children who is not able to sit and attend their milestone. Whenever they attend the milestone with the parents, I am very lucky to watch it. So yes, every day is happiness to get the patient out of, and God has been great. I 100% believe that it is my own hand which cures. So God is also kind that He also helps me healing people. So yes, and whenever the patient get healed, I become happy. I'm a person who hates seeing again. If the patient is coming back with the same problem, I'm like, shit, why did he come back? I feel happy if they go without the ailment.
So my second question is, what are some of the annoying things that patients do?
Most annoying stuff is, why ma'am, why my pain is not going on the first day itself. Okay, on the first day itself. Okay, have some patience. 3 days, 4 days, give yourself time. It will go, no, why my pain is not. I feel that if you're mentally asking yourself lot of why, lot of negativity, the pain stays. And if you're like, no, I'll come out of the pain, actually you come out of the pain. So very, very negative patients, it's a struggle to bring them out of that pain. So that is also slightly annoying.
Thank you so much for joining in, Dr. Pooja, and giving us so much information about health and fitness.